All right, we are ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, fight number one on our card, sponsored by JD.
Wish he'd let us talk.
Introducing and boxing out of the blue corner here tonight, from the United States of America, please welcome into the arena, Exploring with Josh!
Will he be exploring Yusuf's face tonight? We'll find out.
And his opponent, the young man with a plan, trying to catch him if he can. Boxing out of our red corner here tonight, representing London, UK. Let's hear it for Yusuf Armadi!
Which one are you calling this one then for, Jordy? Which one are you going?
2 minute rounds of boxing to determine
Honestly,
the winner.
Lawrence,
both boxers
I
to the centre of the ring.
A
final
right.
word from
All
your referee. Listen to the man in charge and good luck to both of you.
Oh, he's telling them. He's telling them sharp.
Just box. No football.
Just box.
No cricket.
No dog.
Ladies
just
and gentlemen,
boxing.
Let's make some noise for these two boys.
God, he likes talking this MC,
doesn't good,
he?
Though. He's real good. He rhymes almost every word.
I'm going to shut him up.
Yeah. Don't touch him. These two boys will be touching each other in just a few seconds, but in a sort of sinister and boxing way.
Round one.
All right,
out.
We're underway here
the
in YouTube's first ever boxing match.
This is incredible. They touch gloves.
First right hand. Oh,
we know it's
going for it.
Sloppy, don't we?
And this is sort of what we expected from YouTubers, Lawrence.
Yeah, absolutely. What sort of messy punches, slightly scared of each other.
A bit like the editing
yeah.
on YouTube at times.
Tacky.
Oh, they're going for it though.
Really are. We are right ringside here.
You've got such a good view, haven't you?
It is. It's a fantastic
Honestly.
View. Skin glistening in the spotlights. Two guys wearing head guards and silly coloured shorts. It doesn't get any better than this.
This is what I've always dreamed of, Lawrence. I love fighting. I love YouTube. This is my dream.
It looks as if Exploring with Josh is wearing the Chicago Bulls shorts from 1996-1997 season.
And I know Michael Jordan would be proud of them right
genuinely
now.
Genuinely would, yeah. I think that was a gifted ball. Oh,
right hand. Thrown by the American.
If you are watching at home, which I'm assuming you are because you're watching this, unless you are in the arena or streaming this, it's very quiet. There's a hushed silence almost as people aren't cheering in the same way you would at a football match. No. They're worried for these two guys.
Ooh, right hand. That you meant that.
Both these guys look right-handed, of course, but stances indicate that.
Let's be honest, though. The people in the audience, they're not used to watching boxing, a lot of them. You know, they're new to this, so this is their first introduction. And hopefully they keep coming back.
Yeah, if you guys don't know boxing, it's a sport where two men hit each other until one of them loses. There are some big punches being landed there. Some big fights coming up for you guys tonight. Liam Twin versus Jake Twin. The two twins. Isan Gibb versus Max Plays. JMX, the big boy, versus Mike Fox, the slightly smaller guy who is still looking like forward to.
And of course, the main event, KSI versus Joe Weller.
Stuff to
these two lads are not phoning this in, Lawrence.
Absolutely.
They're really going for it. Credit to both of them. And the American seems to have him in the corner. Oh, but he's onside. Oh, and they're swinging for the fences. And that was a game first round by both fighters.
Very nice punches thrown by both fighters. Some people landed some good punches there. But the worrying thing for me was, I thought I saw someone throwing a bit of a knee as they threw themselves into the punch there. I don't want to see that sort of thing.
These are not
tonight.
Professionals, and occasionally mistakes will be made.
Absolutely. As you can see, Brian, it's
we've got
be round
a
two
lovely
in just a
ring
second.
Girl walking around now, explaining to us what round it is. In case you didn't know, we're going into round two.
She just explained that.
Well, she's explaining it very well, Lawrence.
Right.
Credit where it's due. We're seeing the replays now with some of these shots delivered, and it was the wild, wild west, in the words of Will Smith.
Yeah, incredible movie.
Wicked, wicked wild.
Do you think, you know when you're wearing a head guard, Brian, because you've worn a head guard boxing before,
yes.
Does it still hurt in the same way?
Oh, trust me, the head guard is very much needed because these are not pros, obviously.
Yeah.
But it doesn't really take the edge off.
Yes.
You're still going to feel it, and you can still definitely get knocked out with a head guard on.
Both rounds now are going to be very competitive so far.
3 2-minute rounds, for
yeah.
those who are wondering, for the preliminaries and also for the main event, 6 3-minute rounds.
That's a huge
marathon
for both those fighters later on tonight. We're looking for a slugfest. Early punch landed by
body Ahmed. Shot there from Exploring with Josh.
What's the point in landing a body shot, Brian? Is that to sort of wind your opponent?
Take the energy out of them.
Yeah.
suck the wind out of them.
Yeah, it's, well,
keep sucking that wind.
Famous words there from the true George.
Yusuf is bottled into the corner, and Josh is going for it. Oh, and Yusuf is struggling a little bit.
Some good punches landed
there. But he gets himself out of danger, and Josh is gathering himself here.
He managed to get out of that corner there. I was really impressed with the way that he still kept punching, even when Josh was coming out.
To be honest, I don't know if he takes a few more of those punches,
yeah,
how many more he can manage.
Still looking quite light on his feet.
That stiff jab straight into Yusuf's face there.
Yeah, some famous faces watching on as well tonight. You can see those guys.
Celebrities in attendance, Lance. Yeah. Me and you.
Yeah, and Calix.
Josh and Yusuf, yeah, are clearly not trying to blow their load. They're trying to maintain their energies.
As I've heard, happens with many.
Oh, and that's a good punch by Josh. And he's bullying him. But then it's answered by Yusuf.
The referee this evening, I'm going to call him Mr. Morris, is going to let this one run fairly professionally, we're told.
Good movement by the lads. They're considering the lack of training they've had. They're trying their best. I know a lot of people will be tuning in, sitting there saying, oh, well, it's not very good. It isn't nice getting punched in front of thousands of people, and these lads are doing it. To be fair, Josh has got a decent jab.
End of round two.
He's landing that jab repeatedly.
But is that going to wear his opponent down enough?
It certainly seems to be working, Lawrence. I've got to be honest with you.
Really? You think the American at this point is the guy who's looking a little weaker?
No, I think he's landing the better shot, but I think his cardio is an issue. He's carrying a bit extra body fat than Yusuf. Yusuf is more of a slender gentleman.
He certainly is, but he's looking much more trim. He's looking, you can see the muscles on his body.
Right, there's something in the way of him from me now,
it's
so I couldn't
trainer.
Quite
It's his trainer in between
him
you
there.
And him. You can't quite see him. We can see some big punches being landed there by the American and, of course, by the Englishman himself.
I think he needs to carry on with that tactic of bullying him, getting him into the corner and landing those shots.
Whoever did this graphics package tonight, absolutely incredible stuff. Well done.
All right. Time for everyone to get a drink of water, including me.
Do you ever just splash water on your chest?
Every morning,
yeah,
in the shower.
Absolutely, although that is not the same. Round 3 seconds out. Is that a boxing first?
And the touch of the gloves as the gents go into the final round of this fight. They'll be happy if they can just get to the end, I'm sure.
The referee took both gentlemen back to the corner there. Some lovely Adidas All right. gloves.
Touch of the gloves. And a big right hand is thrown. Oh, they're going for it. And I think in the final round, you know you've gone through a lot already. You don't have to worry about cardio. Now you can let it go. And Yusuf is going for it. And he's landing.
Good for the kid.
And there's both of them are landing. Oh, Jake, it's just, though, it's wild. It's wild.
A case of who went down first there. Brian.
Nobody did.
No.
Still standing. Better than they ever did. Mm. Looking like true survivors.
Credit to them. You know what? There's an eerie silence within the stadium at the moment. Josh is...
Yusuf is landing well now. Josh is looking tired, but he answers him.
Josh's coach quieting
him. Oh, that left hand landed.
Yusuf's coach is absolutely throwing every word, every jab with him.
Yeah. His reputation's on the line.
Yeah, it's true.
This is... Ooh, good right hand. Ooh. Josh is just flailing.
Sweat flying off both these fighters at this point. I think
a little too close to me for comfort.
Yeah, I don't...
Both landed there. That could have been a double knockout. Mm.
We are hoping for a double knockout tonight. We look
definitely not. Definitely not.
All right, not
for the record.
Yeah.
Oh, big punch landed.
Wow.
There is 27 seconds left in this fight. Can someone assert their dominance? Prove they're the winner of this?
Just for respect, you kind of want this to go to the judges, don't you?
They've both went in there and really give it hell.
Who would you give it to?
Honestly, mate, I don't know.
I'd go Usyk in this one.
Maybe
the judges are exploring
in this round
other options.
He's growing into the fight.
He's grown into it very, very quickly. Remember, 2 minute round, still very
swing
short.
And a miss
a
from Josh.
Swing.
And that
end
is it.
Of the fight. Both of
end
the gentlemen
of
step
the
away.
Fight.
Referee Gareth Morris steps away. The man from the Midlands.
Come on.
bear with us while we add up the scores, and then we will be able to make the formal announcement of our winner. Bear with us.
You may have heard a little of the off-camera chat there. We're just trying to work out who says what where. That's fine. Brian's going to be interviewing every fighter tonight. You're going to get all the reaction live here on YouTube.
Both boxers to your referee. Ladies and gentlemen,
both gentlemen
on occasions like this, your referee, if he feels the need to pass a comment on a fight, he will do so. And it's quite rare. But this evening, your referee would like to commend both young boxers on a very, very well-fought contest.
That's lovely.
So well done, lads. Well done.
Yeah. Gareth Morris starting off on the right foot tonight. The man from Wolverhampton pulling everyone into his heart.
After close commiserations, the scoring was very, very close indeed. And in fact, only by 1 point, your winner. And boxing out of the red corner here tonight.
Yusuf, I called it. I know boxing. All the boxing. I've consumed it. And that's why I said it.
Well done. Ooh.
Commiserations there to exploring with Josh, but I think we're going to be seeing more of both of these young boxers. They really have got that natural talent, and we're going to get them down at ringside now for an interview. Gentlemen, in 30 years of emceeing boxing, I've never, ever introduced two fighters who are actually twins
30
facing
years.
One another.
Not since Ronnie and Reggie back in the day.
Quite unique.
Doesn't look a day over 40.
I just happened to ask one of our boxers why. He said, why not?
Good point.
So let's see what happens now. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing our two boxers. First of all, boxing out of our blue corner here tonight from Worthing. Let's hear it for Jake to win.
Jake Twin in the red, in case anyone's wondering.
Twin's not the most threatening name,
and
though, is
twin
it?
Brother Jake boxing twin. Out of the red corner here tonight. Also, as you can imagine, from Worthing, let's hear it for Liam to win.
Liam!
Twin. Both boxers, you know the rules. Please come to the centre of the ring. A final word from your referee before the fireworks commence. Here we go. Good luck.
And fireworks tonight. Okay, indoor fireworks, though.
Set yourself at all times and play my commands.
I love this. Gareth has been a really friendly guy ringside to everyone. Young man from Wolverhampton.
He looks like someone who...
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for these two boys!
Liam Twin is in the black, am I right? And Jake Twin's in the red.
Correct. Do you want some popcorn? And there we go.
We go, touch of the gloves.
Both the brothers giving each other a chance.
Let's find out who the harder brother is.
Oh,
little jab there. By Jake.
Jake landing the first punch, but who will land the first significant punch?
I'm worried I'm going to be calling them the wrong name for the entire fight.
You won't, you're all right.
Forgive us. After the clang I dropped in the first round, I fight after the letter.
Believe me, there's going to be a
Jake
lot more
Twin. Oh, wow. Lovely left hook.
Referee struggling to get around these two boys as they're constantly rotating right now. Both of them just feeling the other one out, looking where they're moving.
Liam Twin has it. Oh, he's pulled the trigger.
I think that was the first significant punch landed there, don't you, Brian?
Yeah. Oh, right in the kisser.
Is that the mouth?
He's planting his feet a little bit more. Liam, lighter on his feet, but swinging for the fence.
Is Jake just wearing swim shorts?
He's going for a dip after this.
Yeah.
Jake is backing up. Liam is controlling the centre of the ring more here. He's sort of the aggressor of the two. I wonder if he was like that when he was younger.
You know what, that's often the case with the twins. There's one character.
There's always one evil one.
Yeah, exactly.
We know that.
Well, we can work out which one of them is evil.
One's orthodox, one's southpaw. That's the interesting thing in this fight.
Right, difference in stance.
Of course, Jake is the southpaw here. Awkward style. So they aren't entirely equal.
Does it make it more awkward to box when you both sort of match each other up? You're mirroring the other one. I'd imagine it does.
They're not, though. Oh, Liam. Couple of good punches from him.
Ooh, look at that.
Jake wants to answer. He's not happy. There's a lot of emotion in this one.
Do you think their mums bought them both? The
they haven't got two mums, they're just the one.
You don't know, they might have been from a modern family.
True.
Yeah. There we go, round one is over. Probably a little bit of an anti-climax for a lot of people at home. They're expecting a few more punches to be thrown.
I think it's clear relations here, you know, relations. They're not going to go out there and try and rip each other's heads off like the first fight.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was fireworks.
Yeah.
This was more like a Catherine wheel.
Yeah. Taking my joke there. It's disappointing.
I think it's a hard one to call this.
Mainly because neither of them have really thrown any significant enough punches so far. I'd say so far, if I had to call it, I'd say Liam was the slightly more aggressive of the two and landed just about more.
I would say Liam edged that, but barely.
Yeah. It does seem
and
like
if anyone thing. Argued me on that, I'd probably back down straight away. I'd be like, you were right.
Yeah, absolutely. Fine. And I didn't even try to argue. Of course, in one corner here,
as the referee adjusts his belt, we are ready to get underway.
Stuff. Nice to see Guy Ritchie in one corner tonight.
Touch of the gloves, and Jake is again on the back foot. Liam comes out, and this is more like
now
it.
Now they're into it.
Liam's going for it.
A word in the ear from either coach, do you think? Get out there, show him his boss.
What's this all about?
Yeah, you don't want to be having dinner with him next week and him be able to say, I floored you, mate. Pass Jake. The gravy.
Jake. Jake's starting to assert himself a little bit more, but no. Oh. Liam again comes forward.
Liam can away.
Right. Good push from Drake.
Grey hoodie. Oh, you do run out of things to say when two people are just trying to
Liam.
Hit each other.
Liam's backing up now. They can't quite find their feet here. It's not as fluid as last event.
Because footwork is such a key part of boxing. Wow, a lot of big punches.
Liam landed
there.
Clean.
Wow.
Well, Jake's trying to answer back.
Big punches landed by both brother. Jake managed to land something big there.
On the chin, and this is like nothing I've ever seen before, Lawrence, I've got to say.
Really? I've seen boxing before.
Not like this, though.
Oh,
adjust the headgear. He let him do that, though. Liam, give him a second. Give his brother a second.
And then Liam came straight back at him, almost as if not to thank him for that.
There's a certain style they're imploring here. I can't quite put my finger on it, but it's unorthodox, that's for sure.
It's sort of bursts of punches, followed by a long time of just looking at the other one.
Thinking, that's my brother.
Yeah. I'm so proud of him.
He's doing great.
He's doing great. You are doing great. Just keep going, buddy.
Good shot by Liam there. Both Jake comes back, tries to get him into the corner. Heads rocked, but they are still standing.
It's the interesting side there. You can actually see Jake has a bit more gas in the tank than Liam.
I think both of them try to commit a bit more, plant their feet and go after each other a little bit more. And there was a stumble from both lads at points there. Jake is breathing heavy.
Yeah. They're certainly both taking huge gasps.
I feel like Liam is just ever so slightly better.
Yeah. I mean, do you think it's technique? Do you think it's the fact he's a little lighter on his feet?
I haven't got a clue, Lawrence. I've got to be honest with you, mate.
Good to know.
No idea.
Yeah. Eminem, of course.
It's just awkward, isn't it? It's not your normal. Both of them head up. Chin in the air.
I'm interested in both their gloves. Have they got similar intricate designs? I'd go for something much, much plainer if I was a boxer.
You're very stripped back.
I don't want War and Peace on the back of my gloves. Do you know what I mean?
All right, this is the final round. Maybe we'll have a decisive winner in this one.
The referee there trying to set an example. Touch gloves, lads. Get out there and show them
who's
boss. Will we see some aggression here in the final round? Already, Jake trying to impose himself, pushing his brother into the
just
corner.
Just a blizzard of fists.
Incredible stuff.
Oh, God.
I think you told me about a video.
Who
like
drops
that
first? That's all it seems like. Jake landing repeatedly. Left, right, left.
It's like watching Heathrow Airport.
Liam goes for a big right hook, misses.
Ooh.
Jake hitting them straight punches.
Just so you guys know, we're sitting right ringside here. We've got a great view of both these brothers as Jake runs yet another swipe.
Liam seems to mean business.
One brother dropping his hands there for a second.
Caught him.
you don't want to drop your hands
are
in boxing,
talking?
Do you?
I think they might be
I
talking.
I think they are. Is this wrestling or is
they're
this boxing?
Some words.
Yeah.
They're having some words.
You didn't tidy up last night. I told you to put the Lego away.
You let my batteries of my Xbox controller run out.
Yeah, modern day problems. Where's my action man?
Come on. Jake. They get close in. Liam, swinging, again. He's rocking him a little bit. He's hitting him. He's landing.
Keep landing.
He's landing.
Keep landing, Liam, and I think your brother's going to go down.
But now Jake tries to answer him back,
big
and they're both wobbly.
Backing off. Do you think there's somewhat of an agreement here? Don't put me on. Oh! Big punch landed there by Liam. Liam just wants to put his brother down on the mat, doesn't he? That canvas might be hit in a second.
You've got to say Liam's probably been the better fighter here.
Oh, absolutely. Much more aggressive. I think it's aggression in the amateur area that gets you
ruthless
wins, isn't it?
Aggression.
Mm. Other boxers.
They're in our corner now. Jake swung hard there but missed. I think that's the problem here. There's a lot of wasted energy in this fight.
Certainly so. If you swing through, it's that swing through. Whoa.
Oh, and now Jake answers with a big one.
Jake there. Oh, landing a lot of punches. No more punches thrown after brothers, both brothers touch gloves.
To the end.
Come on, ladies and gents, let's make some noise
well,
for these
well,
twin
that
boys.
That was quite a surreal experience there, wasn't it? Because we've seen brothers land, and every now and again, it's as if they realise, whoa, I'm actually hitting my own brother.
It reminds me of a famous story about Ronnie and Reggie Cray.
Quite interesting, you might not have observed it.
Really?
But yeah, they identical
they
twins,
used to box
and yet
each other.
One of them
did
was
they?
Left-handed
yeah, they beat
and the other guy
each other,
was
apparently.
Wow. Okay.
So
I watched a documentary recently. They didn't mention that at all. Maybe it was a pro-Cray documentary.
And it makes it quite tricky when you're facing somebody who's the opposite to you in the way of being left or right, because the referee, I can just demonstrate, I was a lefty.
Lovely.
Watch what happens. The jab keeps hitting the jab all the time. So you have to try and come round your man to catch him. So it's like looking in the mirror. But I think both boxers did so well at facing an opponent who was also
really like
opposite
the
to them from the point of view of being left or right-handed,
literally.
Respectively.
It's like looking in the mirror.
Total
well,
respect to both these young men as well. Brothers facing one another in the ring in a very gentlemanly way.
Both brothers, both the same barber, I'm told, as well.
Both boxers, please, to your referee for the formal decision. Please face
good lads.
Our cameras. Ladies and gentlemen, again, your referee would like to show absolute respect to both of these young men.
Absolutely.
And give them a big round of applause for facing one another.
Absolute respect.
There is a winner.
Well done to them.
And in France, they say, Liam. By un point, by 1 point. That
wow.
close. Your winner of boxing out of the red he's corner looking. Here tonight. Liam gets it.
There we go. The brother in the black and white shorts.
Congratulations to
it.
Liam. Commiserations to Jake. An international contest of 3 2-minute rounds to determine the winner. Introducing and boxing out of our blue corner here
wow.
this evening. From Northern Ireland, Max Blaze!
That Northern Ireland imagery emblazoned on the shorts.
And the Saudi Arabian man trying to catch him if he can. Boxing out of our red tab here tonight. Who looks to it for? Andy Sangeer!
I've got so much affection for Mark Peters. He's building this fight up so well.
He is a
three, 2 minute rounds of boxing to determine the winner. Your referee will now bring both boxers to the centre of the ring. First of all, we get those gum shields in and those head guards on ASAP. We will then bring our boys to the middle for a final word before the first bell tolls. Good luck to both boxers.
Cal Freezy shouting encouragement at Anis Ongib.
Keep it clean, make it mean. Your referee, here we go.
Boxing, okay, that's what I say, Bright, stop punching, step back, protect yourself at all times, obey my commands. If I want to give you a breather, I'll give you a standing 8-count. Just box, that's all I want you to do. Good luck, lads.
Anis Ongib,
back to your corners.
I'm just
ladies
warning
and gentlemen,
everyone now,
let's make some noise
we'll waste no
for these
time
two boys.
In making this a fight.
Aggressive.
He comes straight ahead like a wrecking machine. In the words of Miley Cyrus, he's coming in like a wrecking ball.
Wow. A locomotive, look at him, straight out, I right in the
you.
Face.
He's going straight.
All right,
straight
okay. To be fair, someone did offer a glove there and he did throw a punch.
Credit to Max, this is not going to be
wow.
a long fight.
One of these guys could hit the canvas. This could be the first boxing match that we see where someone
Max
hits the
Max is moving.
Yeah.
But he's not punching much.
Much nicer. Wow, he almost landed a punch
and he
there.
Is going in and he's trying to land that jab. Is he going in recklessly, though? His chin's wide open.
Yeah, partly. No guard up there for it.
Now he gets those hands back.
Keep going for the body as well.
This pace is fast and furious.
It's unsustainable.
Max is still there. He's taking some big shots, but he's still there.
Max's trainer shouting from the side just to keep moving.
Cabo is going in for the kill, though. And Max is now up against the ropes.
That looks painful. He's keeping his hands up, though.
Keep those hands up, Max. There is a massive weight advantage here for Annie. And now that seems to be taking its toll.
Body blow.
He is relentless here.
Body blow, followed by a blow to the head. This is serious now for Max. He needs to fight back. He needs to give himself something to hang on to.
Max is very tired. But credit to him, he's got the heart of a lion here. He's taken everything Annie's got. And Annie is much more experienced, much more powerful, and hasn't got him out of there yet.
It's credit, though, to Anise Ongit, because the voracious nature which he is going at this match is incredible.
Well, put it this way. I've been watching Newcastle for a long time, and I wish the players were putting them out of graft he does.
It's true.
He's going for it.
Yeah, maybe you should sign him on loan. Free agent. Wow, still landing punches out there. Still
Max is just taking a hammer in here.
As we would say from the podcast, he's relentless.
Credit to Max. Max has rocked there. I think we've got a standing count.
Yes, being
we
told
have.
To stay away.
This is a standing count. Rightly so. He was shook after that one.
Yeah, it's worrying because actually Max's head guard, it needs some adjustment.
It fit, it would help.
Yeah, very good point.
If there are any problems with the stream, we do apologise.
We do apologise, yeah. Hope that you guys are keeping up with this somehow. Remember, if it drops on one channel, it's possible to go to the other one. KSI and Joel are both streaming this simultaneously in what's known as a simulcast.
I thought this would be a bit more of a measured performance by Gibbo. I thought he would come in. I knew he'd go fast, but I didn't think he would be as reckless.
Look how laid back his trainers look. Look at them. They are literally saying to him, you've got this guy now. They just sprayed him like you spray a houseplant.
Gibbo, is that relaxed? He's just giving me a thumbs up. I'm just the commentator.
Look at Freezy on the opposite side of the ring as well. He is loving it right now.
A big Gibbo. He's just giving him the thumbs up. I mean,
he's enjoying this. He's such a show.
We should all enjoy this, I think, a bit more. Like, yeah. There's a lot of seriousness, but this is fun.
This is what modern-day boxing should be like. Two young guys just going at it in the middle of a ring. Wow, Gibb is aggressive again.
Max,
he's down. Gibb has floored someone for the first time tonight.
Credit to Max, though.
Max plays
he
back
was
off.
Straight back
straight
up
back
that
being rolled out of that
well
one.
Well done to him. Credit to him.
Gibb just collecting his breath in the corner here. Breathing heavily, though. He's
the
put
fans
into
are on
it.
Their feet.
Now, the referee's waving this one off.
Rightly
right
so.
Now.
Well done. The
you want to protect your fighter. Gibb goes out to the corner. He's lifted by his trainers. That is the win he was looking for tonight. Relentless, aggressive, incredible. A Nissan Gibb there. Look at that.
As anticipated, Annie went out there and did his thing. Good show of respect by the lads.
The two fighters embrace.
And you know what it is? Max, you've got to give him credit. Like, he took some big shots there.
Yeah, huge shots.
He could take credit from that.
Those are Jaeger bombs. Look at him there. He really owns this ring now. He's standing in the middle of it just saying, this is mine.
Your referee, let's have you facing front.
And this may
ladies and gentlemen, formal announcement as follows. After 1 minute, 30 seconds of the second round, your referee was forced to stop the contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, TKO, boxing out of red tab from Saudi Arabia. Let's hear it. Raise the roof. Anise Ongit. Ladies and gentlemen, fight number four on our card here, sponsored by OP Talent and JD. Three two-minute rounds of boxing
JD
to
Sports.
Determine the winner. Let's introduce these boxers.
The
first of all, coming out of our blue corner here this evening, he's come up from Luton in Bedfordshire. Let's hear it for Mike Fox.
Are you allowed to wear a vest? Why not? Why not, says True Jordan.
And the tall man with a big plan, trying to catch him if he can.
Wow.
Boxing out of our red tab.
JMX looks in great shape, Winslow. Much like the numbers on
Let's
his channel.
Make some noise for
JMX. But he doesn't have his stepmom now. What can he do?
3 2-minute rounds of boxing to determine the winner. Your referee will now bring both boxers to
his head if it wasn't screwed on
the ring. We'll just get that head guard adjusted and then we are ready to go.
The thing is, it is very important to get your head guard right. We saw it in the previous fight, of course, when Max Plays got his head guard slightly taken off. It was and Isan Gibb who was able to capitalize on that because
your
of the uncomfortable
will now
nature
bring
of being
both
hit in the
boxers
face.
To the center for a final word of instruction before we commence the first of three rounds. Listen wow. to the man in charge. Here we go. Good luck.
JMX is cut.
Okay, lads, when I say break, stop, punch and step back. Protect yourself.
This is a mismatch if I've ever seen it physically, but I always want an underdog to win. So I'm kind of rooting.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for these two men.
You're also kind of rooting for... We'll let Mark Peters finish there. We are sort of rooting.
Round one.
And Mike walks straight ahead.
Wow, aggressive.
As JMX tries... Oh, he's going for it, Mike. Mike is not
Credit
scared
Mike.
Of JMX.
Mike is
he's backing him
chasing
up.
Him around
he's
the ring.
He's backing him up.
JMX
and
doesn't
he's
know what
chasing
to do.
Him down.
He's lost his head. They're hugging now. JMX trying to get in there. He's trying to land lower than the belt there. I'm not a big fan of that.
And credit to Mike. He's trying to land that jab and follow it up with a big right hand.
Credit. Small man fighting the big man. Some people build this as David versus Goliath. I said it was JMX versus Mike Fox.
And that was a good overhand right from JMX there. What JMX has got to do here is land that jab, use the distance, pick him apart.
The unorthodox again, isn't it? Unorthodox stance versus...
Oh, and that is landing. That jab is landing now.
Fair to say, one of these two guys skipped leg day.
JMX is doing the right thing and coming around the outside with that right hand.
Yeah.
Trying to land that right hook.
Mike's just taking that, though.
Yeah.
Doesn't look phased at all.
Mike has slowed down a little bit. He came out. Oh, and that was a big right by JMX.
You aren't allowed to punch the back of the head, though, are you?
He's hitting him on the side, though, and he's landing Oof. Repeatedly with that right. Mike needs to get that left hand up and protect himself.
Get that left hand up, Mike. Mike.
Oh, and that is landing again.
After an initial flurry of punches, is now backing off. That initial aggression put JMX on the back foot, but now that back foot is springing him back at
Everything
Mike Fox.
Everything slowed down. Mike needs to... Oh, and that is really... That did land. That Mike has rocked a little.
Wow. Some big punches landing on the side of Mike Fox's head here.
That reach is just too much.
Mike Fox's girlfriend on the side tonight watching nervously.
Oh. This is just repeat. And Mike comes back, but he's caught again. Mike needs to get that left hand up.
End of round one. It's fair to say the aggression of JMX, they're probably one out. A lot of respect for both fighters going out there with that aggression.
Deep breaths by Mike.
Yeah.
And his trainer is not happy. What are you doing? He's really not happy.
Oh, wow, they're actually changing the nature of the head guard right now. They're changing the orientation it's in. The mouth guard comes out, as much water as possible goes in.
I'm very interested to see his trainer is annoyed. His trainer is very annoyed. He's saying, keep that left hand up, because he's going to keep landing on you over and over again if he does. We're seeing pictures, though, now of the initial storm that he did bring to JMX. It just shows if you fight JMX aggressively, he sort of doesn't handle it very well.
No, he doesn't handle being attacked. He's normally the attacker on YouTube, and now he's the attacker in the ring as well. What can Mike Fox do? Everyone on Mike Fox's side here in the arena, they want to see Mike Fox land a big punch. That's all we want to see tonight.
David Goliath, two.
Who's he?
Round two.
Touch gloves, gents. And the train is out.
We are back underway. Oh, and no touch of the gloves there from JMX. He comes straight out. But Mike
is
wrestling.
You're not allowed
Double
to
leg takedown. Can we see some MMA today?
You'd like to see a little MMA. Come on, Mike. Get that head
Mike has
off.
Got a cracking head of hair.
Yeah.
And that right hand is landing again and again and again. Oh, and he's a trip.
He
was
tripped
there.
That doesn't count.
That was a slip.
Yeah.
It's a man's game.
Yeah. Referee Just giving some words of encouragement there to Mike.
We've got them in the corner.
Don't worry
Mike,
about it, he said.
Mike needs to, I think Mike needs to just go for that right hand. Pushing is not really how you win a boxing fight. He's struggling, bless him. He's holding on.
Mike's trying to grab, of course, for JMX here.
Mike needs to start punching high, punching hard. JMX. Mike needs to start throwing, and he throws. Ooh. Right hand by Mike, but he's caught again. He needs to return. JMX. And that was a hell of a shot by JMX.
Mike
and he's knocked
down.
And Mike looks tired.
Furious.
But he gets back up. He's back on his feet.
Credit to him.
I think the physical advantages are just too much in this fight.
Referee Gareth Morris counting into his face. Mike's got to get his hands back
up. Are we going to have a fight called?
Nervously from the side.
Mike is nodding. He's saying, I'm good to go. And he fights on.
Wants to continue.
Credit to Mike. But now JMX smells blood. And it's quite an easy fight for
Big
him now.
Big fists
by the
getting
of
thrown.
It.
Keep your hands up, Mike. That's all we want to see. Don't let
Mike
him bully you out there
anymore.
Mike now fighting back. Of course, JMX has got the height advantage as well. Not only the reach, but the height
He's got
as well.
Everything's in his favour.
Hits
weight, height, reach, everything. Mike is not throwing. Mike just needs to start throwing punches.
End of round two. Mike's trainers need to get in there quick, and they need to have some pretty stern words with him, words of encouragement, which are going to help him get through round three. Just make this respectable. Do you think that's possible?
So I've just heard his trainer say to Mike, fight him. Fight him.
That's a good point.
I don't care what you need to do. Fight him. Punch him.
Look at them. They're cooling them down as fast as they can in that corner. We're seeing JMX, who's looking very confident, very calm, very cool, very collected.
That trainer is literally just shouting, fight him, fight him, fight him. I think it's good advice, though, because you can see in the first 20 seconds, when you bring the storm to JMX, he backs off. He didn't really know what to do with that.
No, it's true.
But the thing was, once the cardio took its toll a little bit, your JMX being a gym lad, didn't really have an answer for it, did Mike?
10 seconds.
I'm a little worried for Mike Fox in this final round, I've got to say. Because JMX,
I just hope it's not a bad one.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Mike's brave to get into this ring with JMX. JMX is a huge
seconds
guy.
Out.
You're talking a 20-pound
round.
Difference again.
Absolutely.
Again.
Yeah. Referee just stopping it just for a second.
JMX is desperate to get at him here. He smells blood. He sees weakness. He's ready to pounce.
Looking into his eye there, Mike Fox a little worried. I think his trainer was also a little
I think
worried
if we're
as
asking
well.
These questions, we probably should call it a day.
Yeah. Let's just take a second to be respectful towards the fight as well here. Obviously, if you get hit massively in the eye, for the first time, you're probably going to be attacked by someone like JMX. Hopefully
they're not pros. Rest. They're just regular guys who make YouTube videos for a living. You know what I mean?
You
they're not designed for this sort of thing.
You've got to protect
I
these
think
guys.
We're going to wave this off.
Yeah, we probably are. Yeah. Looks as
no.
Oh, wait.
No,
wow.
We are underway.
Incredible. JMX goes in for the kill again.
The lad's got hot.
Yeah. Wow.
And he's going for it now.
They've locked up.
And we're going to see a break. Ref breaks.
Mike needs to protect himself.
And Mike with a jab.
Slapping the canvas.
Good right hand by JMX.
Oh, JMX is just landing. Not hard punches, though. He's just hitting the body.
We've got a break by the ref.
Referee's going to have to
keep breaking. That was a good body shot by JMX. Back of the head. And he's bullying him. He's bullying him. And Mike is in the corner. It's time to wave this off, rightly so.
That one's done. Credit to JMX there.
JMX's corner celebrate as if this was an equal fight.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, JMX. You just won what was a massively weighted fight. But credit to Mike Fox, who stepped into the ring, was more than brave enough to go up against him. I've got a lot of respect for both fighters out there in the ring, of course. Out the ring, it's very different. It's fair. Mike, well done.
Well done to both lads. They got on the ring. They gave it their all.
We're slightly lost for words there because we both know what a big night this was.
For Mike.
For Mike.
And I think we're about to see it could still be a big night.
Yeah.
Bear with me.
Yeah. Bear with us. Can I come for this, Jordy? Can I come for this interview? Yeah.
Oh, hello.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you'll agree, a big round of applause there for both boxers. We're just waiting to get them into the middle here so that I can make the formal announcement.
Both fighters called into the centre of the ring now.
Well, I'm sure you'll agree, both Mike, boxers came in there to give it their all. They
real
did
respect
give it 100%.
For Mike. Great night for him.
Winner.
Real respect.
Now, I'm about to give you that formal decision. After 1 minute 14 seconds of the third round, Mike Fox from Luton in no fit state to continue. So your winner by way of TKO and boxing out of our red corner from Winslow. Give it up for JMX.
Credit to JMX.
And that
but
is what we like to see at the end of a contest.
To Mike
Fox.
Fucking Vidal, where's he at? Dida, my PT, and my beautiful girlfriend.
Can we get your girlfriend over here?
Come here. Bro, I'm knackered, you know. Wait, where's my man?
Lawrence has got something for you.
Jesus Christ. Oh, Matt, oh, bro, I'm gonna get emotional, you know. Jesus, I never thought I'd cry on camera, man, fuck. Get in the ring. Oi, I love you. Fucking hell, man. And, oi, I don't think I can say this with a serious face, but, oi. Will you marry me?
Yes! Yes! Oh my
touch a moment there for Mike Fox, who proposes to his girlfriend.
I think we're going to all say a big well done to Mike Fox.
Thank you, man.
Carl Frazee gives
ladies
me the
and
look
gentlemen,
of it's about
this event
to go down.
Sponsored by JD, brought to you by OP Talent and Upload Events. This, ladies and gents, is the biggest boxing for business, the biggest white-collar boxing event ever to be presented in the UK.
Ever.
And you are part of it here tonight. Let's welcome the boxers into the ring. Are you ready?
There is an electric atmosphere around this arena.
Ladies and gentlemen from Eastbourne, please welcome Joe Oella.
Boos, screams, cheers. Joe Oella comes out to a remix of the XX Serious.
There he is. There's Joe.
This man has built.
I fucking
this
love this kid. Sorry.
There's tingles going down my spine right now. This place is, everyone has their eyes fixed on the corner with Joe.
Credit to everyone involved, yeah, for YouTube. This is
are you ready?
Ready?
Joe knows how to work a crowd with music.
Are you ready?
This guy's done DJing. He's done his own tracks before. This is going to be a mega mix of Joe Weller classics.
Joe looks very calm. Very calm right now. Composed.
It's fair to say that some of these guys might be suffering from sleepless nights after this. Joe Oella walks right by us. He looks in peak physical condition. Steps up to the ring and Mark Peters parts the ropes for Joe Oella to work the crowd. Pacing around, raising his right hat. His team looked prepared. His team looked as focused as he do. Look at Joe. Look at him. He's loving it. Red shorts emblazoned with the JD. snake skin.
You sent me a picture of them last night.
They look beautiful.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the lights go down.
We now go to his opponent. Coming into the ring, the man with the plan, trying to catch Joe if he can. Please welcome from Watford, the Nightmare KSI!
The Nightmare.
But what's his music choice? The lights go up around him.
Hey, hey, hey.
This is serious. Look at that face. He's drinking it in. JJ passes by the commentary table. His team part the ropes for him.
JJ mouthing every word to his son. Wow, that is the gown that you'd expect from him, though, isn't it?
No eye contact from Joe Weller.
Joe turns his back on JJ.
Both of them just owning the space.
I'll tell you what, right? Say what you want. Say they're not pros, say they don't know how to box, whatever you want. These two lads know how to put on a show.
Joe Weller looks focused. People have been trying to make eye contact with Joe for the past 5 minutes. I've seen them around the ring. No one got a look in the eye from Joe.
Although I did get a wink.
You've been waiting for. This is the main event of tonight. This contest will take place over 6 3-minute rounds to determine the winner. Sponsored by JD and brought to you by OP Talent and Upload Events. As I say, guys, this is the biggest, unbelievably the biggest white collar boxing contest ever in UK history. Please welcome our two boxers into the ring one more time. I
can't believe this is happening.
The young man boxing out of our blue corner here tonight. He's up from Eastbourne. He means it. Let's hear it for Joe Oella.
Joe gets a massive cheer from this arena. There's a lot of people on his side in this room.
His opponent in total preparation for this evening's event and boxing out of our red tab here tonight. The man from Watford. You know him. The Nightmare. KSI.
Wow. JJ reveals the gunshot.
There is no fear from either fighter.
It's time for round one.
That's for sure.
JJ,
this is serious. Do you want to take a seat for this?
I'm going to take my seat. Well, I'm getting major love from the crowd. JJ told me before the fight that this wouldn't bother him in the slightest, though. They're exchanging words, and Joe has just said something to JJ.
JJ replying, and Joe laughing it off.
Both laughing and smiling right now. But in seconds, they're going to try to take each other's
head
off.
And then we are good to go, ladies and gents.
What's going on, Joe?
Slight delay, but we are there. We are nearly ready. Are you ready?
JJ said this was going to be easy. Let's see how easy this is. I'm interested, because a lot of talk has gone into this.
There's a lot of nervous energy surrounding this ring, and you can't imagine.
JJ looks in fantastic physical condition. Joe,
ladies and gentlemen, this is boxing for business. I hope you're ready for it, because the business is about to start.
Transformation,
right here.
I mean, that,
right
to be fair,
here at the top of Box Arena.
Although it's very similar for Joe, because Joe has bulked up massively. They're in a very similar weight category right here.
Both boxers, please, to the
4 kilograms
of the
difference.
A final word from
10 pounds.
Here we go.
Words being exchanged between the two of them. Look at Weller's just nodding at KSI. KSI spits words back at him. The referee stopping the words.
Now that Joe can fight him, he doesn't seem as fazed. He seemed a little bit more subdued yesterday. He seems quite happy to go into this now.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for these two boys.
This is it. Are you ready? We've got a fight.
Joe's side is gassed. KSI's side is gassed. The referee gets the thumbs up. It's seconds out on YouTube between KSI and Joe Weller.
JJ looks to the trainers, and Joe looks to come straight ahead.
Joe looks like a
and Joe right is walking straight ahead.
Both these guys are looking for a big punch as they're down.
JJ landing the jab early. JJ landing the jab early. Right hook by JJ. Another jab by JJ. Joe not answering. Joe hasn't thrown a punch yet. Joe needs to start throwing. Joe needs to throw. Joe needs to throw a punch. And he does.
Look.
And he does throw. And he lands.
If you had.
This is Joe sitting back waiting.
One shot.
And he does throw. And he lands again. And he's making a fight out of it. This is a fight.
JJ's on the back foot.
One moment.
And he's put his tongue out. JJ though.
Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous. But on the surface, he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, loud. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity. Choke, he's so mad, but he won't give up. He won't have it, he knows. His whole back to these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's pro. He's so stagnant, he knows. When he goes back to this mobile home, that's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody better go capture this moment and hope it don't do it. Lose his health in the music, the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity goes once in a lifetime. You better lose his health in the music, the moment you own it.
Between being a father and a prima donna, baby mama drama screaming on her too much.
Jaw rock. Jaw is rock.
Counter with a big head.
Stuff I hate. Everything they complicate. Everything they steal your fate. Every day, but you can't believe it. Take yourself far away from nothingness. Million miles from emptiness. Stuff I hate. Everything they complicate. Everything they steal your fate. Every day, but you can't believe it. Take yourself far away from nothingness.
Save
goes over to his corner to gather his mind, take it back out.
And here we go. This surely is the end of the fight. JJ has got so much power.
It's waved off.
Well, that is not.
The sidemen rush in. Joe's team surround him.
Let me just keep Joe away from him.
Joe is looking away from this, but there are huge scenes of the sidemen.
JJ is lifted on the arms. He's won the fight. He celebrates. Everything he said was great. Credit to JJ. He was phenomenal in this fight.
Look at that close angle of him. That is a man in full confidence.
Do you know what it is? The transformation he's been through. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. The trainer. You can see how close they are. Him and his trainer. They're like best mates, aren't they?
Yeah. JJ said to you beforehand, he'd continue this after this fight.
He might want to call someone out. I think I might have to get into the ring after this.
Go get it. True Geordie heads towards the ring, and you can see
everyone
wants to be on camera
here. We have at ringside
JJ brings his brother Deji closer towards
him. Shores. I'm hoping he's
does
in
Deji
the house
get into the ring
and he's going to come into the ring. I'm looking for Derek Chisora. Where are you, Derek?
Wow, Derek Chisora coming in to present this belt to KSI. Huge.
We have Derek Chisora into the ring.
On the
please.
Side there. JJ just shouting at all the people on the side. Embracing. Derek Chisora is in the ring now. JJ embraces him. Well, that is going to be little solace for Joe Weller, who hears his second name shouted around the arena.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now go to our formal announcement. Your referee will bring both boxers to the center of the ring. I'm sure you'll agree, everyone in this copper box here tonight, both boxers deserve our respect and they deserve to be attributed for a great fight they put on here tonight.
See True Geordie in the background there. You see KSI in the foreground, the referee holding his glove, which is emblazoned with all the things he was going to do to Joe in this fight, all the things that he promised he would do, and ultimately what he delivered on. Incredible scenes here from KSI. Look how relieved he looks. Look how happy he is that everything that he said he'd do, he fulfilled.
Here we go.
Joe also.
Ladies and gentlemen.
For the ring. Look at the pride on Joe's
a
face. A bloody face,
six,
but a proud rounds, man.
But 1 minute, 30 seconds into the third round.
His trainer
your
takes
referee
the blood off his
face. Was forced to stop the contest. Your winner. By way of TKO from Watford, let's hear it for the Nightmare KSI.
KSI gets
the
belt,
championship belt
put around his
none other than one
waist.
Of the greatest heavyweights ever to rock up from our shores. World heavyweight contender Derek Chisora in the house with us
incredible
here tonight.
Stuff.
I'm now going over to you.
JJ, you did everything you said you were going to do. How do you feel?
I talked the talk, and I walked the walk, motherfucker. Yo, on the roll though. Joe, you're way harder, you're way tougher than I thought. And fair play, bro, respect for it. Respect for you getting in the ring. And giving me a tough battle, bro. Yo.
Is there anyone you want to thank?
Nah, I want to thank my mom, my dad, my bro, The Sidemen, you know it. I want to thank all the friends as well, everyone who helped me out. Faye Sensei, I see you, Ooze. Dita, my PT bro, thank you bro. Sarah, she was my nutritionist, thank you. Leon, thank you for destroying me in sparring and helping me defeat anything. And of course, Vidal Riley, remember that name, ladies and gentlemen, because he is going to be a boxing world champion. Mark my words.
Vidal Riley. Vidal, any words from you?
Listen, he stuck to the game plan. He done well. I'm proud of him. Everyone came out today to support. They're the true winners. Everyone that traveled, they're the true winners.
Shout out to all the fans that had my back from day one, y'all. From day one.
Who's the athlete now?
He really was. One important thing, listen, Joe, you gave a fucking good fight, excuse my language, you done a good fight.
It's YouTube, it's okay, it's okay.
He's tough, he's very tough, tougher than we expected.
Yo, I'm gonna be honest, Joe, I don't like you, but I like what you stand for, okay? Mental illness is a real thing, ladies and gentlemen, and I want this event to showcase that anyone who's suffering from mental illness, you are not alone, okay? And you should never, ever, ever give up, okay? All my life, I've had people tell me, you can't do this, you can't do that. YouTube, they said that you can't get 100,000 subscribers, 1 million subscribers, 10 million, 17 million. And what did I do? I proved them wrong. Same with the music. People said I couldn't do music. And you know what? I proved them all wrong. I came out to a song featuring Big Zoo, one of the most underrated grime artists today. And he was with me for all of this, and I'm just proving all of them wrong. Same with movies, I did the same with that. And of course, with boxing, they said 8,000 people were gonna see my head knocked out on the canvas. And the millions of people watching. Look at me now, motherfucker. Look at me now.
You said before this fight, you had something planned. Is there anything you wanna say to someone out there? You said you wanted to call someone out.
Well, obviously, man's got this belt right now. If any YouTuber wants it, you can come get it. Jake Paul, Logan Paul, any of the Pauls, I don't care, bring it. Same, yo, if any celebrity wants it, yo, where's Rio? Where's Rio Ferdinand? If Rio wants it, I know you're doing your Betfair thing. If you want some, bro. I'm ready, yo.
After that, I don't think so, but...
I'm ready, dude. 4 months, bro. 4 months training, that's all I had. But anyway, thank you to all the fans that came out. Hopefully you enjoyed the show. Commiserations show. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it.
Everybody, your winner, KSI!
Champion steps to one side.
I want to work with Joe Weller now. Joe, it didn't go how you planned. You tried your hardest. How do you feel, bro?
Obviously, I'm gutted. Like I said, I thought we did everything we could do to defeat JJ in this fight. But at the end of the day, he's prevailed. He's a heavy hitter. Those blows, they stun you. You know what I mean? So 100% respect. JJ's taking this seriously. He's put in the work. And yeah, that power is lethal. But regardless, I've taken something much bigger away from this whole experience. I feel like I've grown as a person, being surrounded by my team and my family and my friends. And I didn't get a championship belt, but I've got much more in life, I feel, from this. So I'm still happy.
You have a lot of people here right now who love you. I'm one of them. What do you want to say to all your fans out there who've come here to support you?
I just want to say, I respect every single one of you. The support you show, the loyalty, it's honestly, it blows my mind. I know I'm never 100%, well, not always 100%, but the fact that you guys are there from the viewers to my friends to my family, every single one of you are loyal and you support, and it's just, honestly, it's incredible, and I just want to say a thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your fighters, KSI, Joe Weller. Well done, lads.
two incredible contenders
ladies
there.
And gentlemen, one more time, give a big round of applause for both boxers. And of course, your winner, the Nightmare, KSI.
Well, it was a dream for him tonight as he stepped out into the ring. He did exactly what he said he would.
JD and all of us here, OP Talent, Upload Events, we'd like to wish you a very good weekend, what is left of it. We sincerely hope you have a very, very safe journey home and enjoy the rest of what promises to be a great Saturday night. Ladies and gents, thank you so much for joining us, not only here at the Copper Box Arena, but around the world, live online.
Thanks for watching.
We thank you. Good night.
Whatever stream you're watching on, have a good night. We'll see you here again real soon in this chat.